I want to teach you a shortcut to go between fractional and binary numerals to decimal numerals. And this shortcut really relies on us remembering just how we read decimal numbers or fractional decimal numbers. For example, here I have 0.125. That's not the right way. Like, that's not going to be the helpful way. Here's the helpful way. This is 125 and then I need to find this place, right? So tenths, hundredths, thousandths, thousandths. Now recall, 125 thousandths is the same as 125 thousandths. Now we could simplify that fraction, but let's not worry about that. Here's how we can quickly write or quickly pronounce a decimal numeral and then write it as a fraction. Let's look at this numeral again. So I want to change this to base 10. This stuff over here, that's a 2 and a 4, so this is 6 and something. It's a bad 6. Okay, 6 and something. Now, just look at this part. If you look at the number or the numeral 0101, well, this would be a 1. There's no 2s. This would be a 4, and there's no 8s. So this is 5. That means that this is 5. Let's see, that's halves, quarters, eighths, sixteenths, sixteenths. This number is 6 and 5 sixteenths. And the way I did that was I took this part after the radix point, I don't remember how the angry computer told me to pronounce it. I take the number after this point, pretend like none of this is here, figure out what the value is. Here it was 5, and then put it over the place value that I have at the end here, which was the 16th place. So this is 6 and 5 16ths. Okay, let's look at another one. So here I want to look at just these guys first. So 110101. This is a 1. I have no 2s. This is a 4. I have no 8s. This is a 16. This is a 32. 32 plus 16 is 48. 52, 53. This numeral is 53. And now this is the 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64th place. This is 53 64ths. Okay, I figured out that's 53. I put it in its place. It's 64ths. Let's do one more quick. Here I have 1110 or 0.1110 base 2. Again, I just want to look here. 1110. That's no 1, but a 2, a 4, and an 8. So this is 14. And then checking my places, a half, a quarter, an eighth, a 16th. This is 14 16ths. Now, 14 16ths reduces to 7 eighths. And I don't know if you know this, but in binary, 7 eighths is 0.111 base 2, which you would know, right? Because this number is 7 and that's the eighths place. So notice that this extra zero on the end doesn't change anything, but it makes it so that we'd have to reduce. Okay, but there's your shortcut. If you want to change a number written as a binary fraction or a fractional part of a binary numeral, so with the radix point, just take those digits after the point, change them into a number, put that number over the last place in your numeral.